Good afternoon, friends. Now we are discussing the first module in operation management. So that is introduction to production management. So what is operation management? It refers to the management of any productive system, whether you are producing a product or rendering service to the society. So the managing any productive system is called as operation management. So what is production? It is the process through which some products or goods will be created for the use of the customers. Services. So here we are not producing any product. So, but the services include different non-manufacturing sectors of economy, such as transportation system, health system, banking system, postal system, warehousing, etc. So functions within any business organization. So main function is finance function. Under finance function, I have operations function. Under operation function, I have marketing function and human resource function. So each one of the above function are interrelated to each other and interdependent on each other for the smooth functioning of that particular organization. So what is operation function? So it is management of all production activities within the industry. It includes planning, scheduling, quality control, inventory control, etc. So what is inventory? So inventory is nothing but the stack of goods. So maybe it is the stacking the raw materials or stacking of finished goods. So that is, it is the responsibility of the organization to take care of the raw materials received until it is converted to the final product. And once the finished product is ready, so the organization has to take all the measures to protect the finished goods so that it is intact until it reaches the end user. So finance functions. So it is the financial management which is dealing with how an organization is raising the funds to run the organization and how it uses uses the funds to run the organization. Then marketing function. So the performance of any business activity which direct the flow of the goods and services from the producer to the consumer. So from the producer, the finished product will reach to the consumer. So that the performance of making this finished product to reach from the producer to the consumer. So will be dealt with marketing functions. Then HR functions. So it takes care of recruitment, placement, training, safety and health of workers. So these are the different functions within the organization. So that is the finance functions. Under that I have operations functions. Under that we have marketing functions and human resource functions. So these are the different functions within the business organization. Then some definitions of operation management. So it is simply putting together inputs, the four M's, that is men, material, money and machines and even technology, and transferring them into the final products and services in terms of quality, quantity, time and location that will best meet the organization's objective. So operations management is putting together all these inputs, so men, materials, money and technology, transferring them into the final products. In between, so the quality, quantity, time and location, all these are mattering in the production management. So finally, the organization goal is to maximize the profit. So managing these things will be taken care by operation management. So this is one definition. If you see the other definition, it is the process of effectively planning and regulating the activities of that part of the enterprise. So as we discussed earlier, we have different functions. So that is HR functions, then marketing functions, then finance functions, then production functions. So how effectively the planning is made and regulating the activities of these parts of the enterprise, which is responsible for actual transformation of materials into the finished products. So how effectively the planning is made and how that planning is executed very effectively, so that the transformation of raw materials will be taken place into the finished goods and reach the final end user. So these are two definitions we discuss here. So like this, our philosophers of operations management have given a number of definitions. So role of the production or operations management. So to convert the available capital into physical resources, that is raw material required for production. So that is first, foremost thing is to avail the raw materials required. Then to convert the physical resources like men, materials, machine. So using these 4 M's, so we are converting the raw materials into the saleable goods and services. So the production department of any organization is engaged in the above two major activities. So that is availing the raw materials required for the production and conversion of these raw materials into the saleable goods and services. So we have to follow the set of functions as given below. So the first one is to forecast the demand for products and determine all the production requirement. So before producing any product, it is necessary to forecast the demand for that particular product and determine what all the requirements for the production process. Then to arrange and bring together all the inputs, especially the 4 M's what we discussed earlier for the production. Then to arrange for services, that is maintenance, storekeeping, material handling, quality control, etc. required for the production. Then to produce the goods at minimum possible cost and time. So at the same time to produce the goods of acceptable quality and the right quantity. So the quality of the goods produced should be acceptable and it should be in right quantity, and the cost incurred in the production should also be minimal, and within the possible time the production has to be completed. Then to effectively utilize all the factors of production and service facilities. Then to take the strategic level decisions concerning the product design and production system to influence, that is capacity planning. So what is the capacity of the production plant? Then production planning, what are the machineries available for the production? Then new product identification, any necessity of producing the new product. Then cost control, then process design, layout planning, design of material handling system. Thank you, friend.